9.8, okay, if you are having a body of mass 1 kg, force applied on this body by earth will be 9.8 newton.
Okay.
Is this clear?
Yes.
This we have completed. We have done. If mass increases, force as well will increase. If 2 kg, it will double it. 19.6 newton. Force will be applied by the earth. This is clear? Okay. And this force is nothing but weight of the newton, weight of the body. This force is nothing but weight of the body. Okay. So today we'll be discussing acceleration due to gravity. So since, what do you mean by acceleration?
Rate of change of velocity.
Rate of change of velocity. That means velocity changes. And when does the velocity of a body changes? When some force is being applied on the body, the moment the force is being applied, so the time duration for which the force is applied, during that time duration, the velocity of the body changes. This we have studied. Okay. Now, if a body we drop from some height, earth is there. So, is the center gravitational force? It is always directed towards the center, that is, every body will be attracted towards the center of the earth. Now, as it falls, what happens? A constant force is applied during the whole journey. A constant force will be applied equal to the gravitational force. Due to that, its velocity is going to change. Due to that, the body's velocity is going to change. Whether it will increase or decrease?
Increase.
It will increase.
The reason is motion is action. As well the force in this direction. Yes, because of the gravitational force, the body is attracted towards it. Therefore, motion in the same direction as well as the force in the same direction. Therefore, velocity will keep on increasing. Every moment, the velocity will increase. Okay, so what we call, this is acceleration due to gravity. Acceleration due to gravity means acceleration due to gravitational force. This is clear? Okay, if I'm dropping a stone and a feather, okay, and there is no medium. If we are dropping a stone and a feather and there is no air, it's vacuum, in vacuum, which will reach first?
Both will reach at the same time.
Both will be going to reach the same time. So whatever their mass is, good afternoon. Whatever their mass is, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. They are going to reach at the same time. That is, acceleration produced in both the bodies will be same or different?
Same.
Same.
It will be same. The velocity will change. Same. The change in velocity will be same. The acceleration produced in both the bodies will be same. Okay. So, whatever shape, whatever size of the body you take, whatever mass you take, it doesn't matter. The acceleration produced in these two bodies, in the body, is independent of the mass, size, and shape of the body. This is clear? So only one force is acting, that is the gravitational force. That's why we usually say the acceleration produced in these bodies is called acceleration due to gravity. This is acceleration due to gravity. Because this acceleration depends only on gravitational force. Therefore, we say the acceleration produced in this body is acceleration due to gravity. And we denote it with G. We denote this acceleration produced as G. This is clear? Okay. Now, if air is there, which body is going to reach first?
Stone.
Stone.
Stone is going to reach first. So, what is the reason? Because now air will be there. So, as body moves, it has to cut through the air. Okay, so there will be viscous drag as well. Viscous force will act. That is, viscous force of air will oppose the motion. Here as well, feather, the viscous force of the air will oppose the motion. So here, more viscous force will be there as compared to stone. Stone is more compact. It is less compact, more surface area. So viscous force is more here, as well as buoyancy. Buoyant force that we'll discuss in next chapter. That is, okay, you have seen it. Okay, buoyant force is like this. Okay, What is thrust? Normal force. Thrust is nothing but force. Yes. Thrust is nothing but force. Yes, sir. Now, yes, sir. If we take in upward direction, force applied in upward direction, it will be upward force and we call it as up thrust. Thrust, but in upward direction. How it is there? For example, you have seen, taken water. Okay, I'll be giving just a little bit idea about this. Buoyant force or up thrust force. Up thrust only. Force is thrust only. So, put a ball over here. You will feel a little bit weightless. Yes or no? It will float in water.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, I can't able to see you.
Okay. Is anyone not able to see me?
Sir, you are clearly visible.
Yes, sir.
Sir, you are clearly visible, sir.
Okay, fine.
Sir, very clearly.
Do one thing.
Sir, you are visible.
Okay, once. Okay.
Sir, I rejoined my class 2 times.
Okay, Ankush, see it once. Can you see it now?
No, sir. Sir, your name is also not coming.
Okay, rejoin it. Rejoin.
Sir, I think she have to pin someone.
It's fine because I have spotlighted me, so I'll be pinned. Okay. Ankush, join it once again. Join once again. Okay. So see here, which force is acting downward? Gravitational force. Gravitational force is acting downward. We represent it with F. Okay. But water is opposing its motion to go down. By what force? Upward force. The water is opposite motion to go down, the ball motion, and that is called as up thrust. That this is called as up thrust. The upward force applied by the water. Similarly here, air applies force, upward force. And because of that, the acceleration produced will be different in them. Here, acceleration will be less because resultant force will be less. This is the force due to gravity, but these two force has to be separated. Viscous force, that is viscous drag, and the up thrust force. These force are to be separated from this force. So resultant force will be less. Resultant downward force will be less on feather as compared to stone. Therefore, acceleration produced in feather will be less. So it will take time to reach the ground. Viscous force. Okay, viscous force depends on, you have seen. Viscous force is kind of you have seen different materials, like different liquids we take, for example, oil, kerosene oil, mobile oil we have taken.
Sir,
which is more dense?
Of air only. Sir, air force only, sir.
Air as well. Viscous force is air as well as liquids as well. So let me explain with liquids. For example, you have taken less dense liquid, kerosene. And here you have taken glycerin. What is the density of glycerin? I think 1300, I think, kg per meter cube. Kerosene around 700 something, I think, 700. Olive oil you take, that's 900 only. So for example, you have taken olive oil. It's around 900 kg per meter cube. Okay. So if you are told that a channel has been filled with glycerin and olive oil, in which channel you'll be able to walk with less resistance?
In the olive oil.
In olive oil, you feel less resistance, you can walk. You can walk less resistance, but in glycerin, you will have more resistance. So this resistance offered by the glycerin is nothing but viscous drag, viscosity. Viscosity, that means it is having more density, it is more viscous. It is less viscous. Viscosity, viscous drag. Okay. So here, more the density, you will have more viscous drag. Here, olive oil, less viscous drag will be there. This is called, okay. In higher classes, you study 11th. Even I have forgotten most of the stuff regarding viscosity. The Reynolds equation is there, some more is there. So for timing, it is clear. Now see here, air has some density. So there will be friction applied by the air as well. Take it like this, ball is moving. It will apply the friction. Friction between the air and the ball will be there. or between the feather end, there will be there. This frictional force is nothing but viscous drag. Okay? This frictional force is nothing but viscous drag. So more the denser the air, more the viscous drag. More bigger the body, more the viscous drag. This is clear? Okay, buoyant force is already clear. That is up thrust that is being applied. Okay. I think more viscous means which can flow more easily, I think. Okay, I'll check it once and it helps. So, till now what we have discussed? A body, its falls, and due to this force due to gravity. Due to gravitational force, there is a change in velocity. That velocity increases. And how the velocity is increasing? Is it uniformly increasing? See here, this force is constant force acting on the body. It means the body will be uniformly accelerated. Yes or no? It will be uniformly accelerated. That is, acceleration produced each moment is same. In each moment, the acceleration produced is same. Okay, the velocity changes uniformly each second because constant force is acting on the body. Therefore, it is called uniformly accelerated motion. It is freely fall body of, okay, if a stone is dropping, if it is moving downward towards the earth, it will be uniformly accelerated motion. Okay. So this all we have discussed, the rate at which the velocity of the freely falling body is changing, that is nothing but acceleration due to gravity. And is it a vector quantity or a scalar quantity, acceleration?
Vector quantity.
It's a vector quantity. How we get the direction of the acceleration?
By the direction of velocity.
By the direction of the velocity. That is, we are getting the direction in which direction the velocity is changing. The direction in which the velocity of the body is changing, or we can simply say in which direction the motion of the body is. That gives the direction of the acceleration. Okay. This all we have discussed earlier as well. Okay. Now on the Earth surface. On the Earth surface, mainly there is a difference in acceleration due to gravity. It is maximum at the poles of the equator.
At poles,
we have the maximum acceleration due to gravity. That is, gravitational force is maximum on the poles. As we move from poles towards equator, it decreases. So there will be slightly less acceleration due to gravity at the equator. There is slightly less acceleration due to gravity at the equator. Okay.
Sir, but what is the reason?
Okay, there is a reason behind this also. Okay. See here, how the Earth rotates. Like this only?
Sir, west to east.
West to east. Okay, if you are taking east direction. West. West to east.
East rotates.
It rotates from where you are seeing, from top or below. It rotates like this only. First Japan, then India, then New York. If sun is here,
yes,
first
sir.
Japan, India, then New York. Like this it is rotating, west to east, from west to east it is rotating, okay? Now see here, as it rotates, what about this person here? Does he feel some outward force or not? No force will be felt because he is at the poles. Okay, we can take it like this. If you take a ball, put a stuff here, if you rotate, do it get thrown away? No, if it is the center. The point, the axis, if it is lying on the axis, it won't be get thrown. But if you are putting it on the equator, that is perpendicular to the axis, as you rotate, it will be thrown away. It will be thrown away. Yes or no? Okay,
yes,
see it
sir.
Like this. If you are, this is the North Pole, and here is the body. We are seeing from the North Pole on the top, and this is the body here. As it rotates, this way it will be rotating, as it rotates. This body want to go in which direction? This body want to continue in this direction. It want to go in tangentially, but there is continuous force. Which force is acting? gravitational force. Because of gravitational force, this gravitational pulls, it's towards it. Every moment it pulls. So see, there's a constant force, outward force as well. There's a constant outward force as well because body wants to go in this direction. It means it wants to travel in this direction, but gravitational force is pulling it. So resultant gravitational force will be less or not? There will be less because some gravitational force is being utilized to move the body towards it, in, to change the direction of the body. Yes or no? So to overcome that, some gravitational force is lost. And the resultant gravitational force will be acting on the body. But whereas somebody, anybody lying on the poles, it will be there stationary. No force is required. So only the gravitational force will be acting. Therefore, there is more gravitational force on the poles. And as we move towards the equator, it keeps on decreasing gravitational force. As gravitational force decreases, acceleration due to gravity also decreases. So maximum on the poles and least at the equator. This difference is not much, very slight bit less it is. So usually we take the mean value of the acceleration due to gravity, that is 9.8 meter per second square. This is the mean value of acceleration due to gravity. Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay. So till now we have studied some laws. What was the second law of motion? Newton's second law? F equals to ma. We have studied this one.
To rate of change of momentum.
Yes. If there is a body of mass m, and now which force is acting? Gravitational force, F equal to ma, Newton's second law. F equal to mg, because acceleration due to gravity is g. Okay. And we have studied gravitational law as well, Newton's gravitational law. What it is? F equal to
g into m into n upon r
square. For example, Earth we take, or any planet you take. This is the mass of the planet. This is the mass of the body. This is the gravitational constant, and this is r square. Now we are going to derive a relation between smaller g, that is acceleration due to gravity, and gravitational constant. Okay. So we are going to derive acceleration due to gravity in terms of this g. Okay. So can we equate them? This is the gravitational force.
Sir.
And this is the gravitational force. We did that, but we're going to get mg equal to gmm upon r square. Small m will cancel. G equal to capital G upon gm upon r square. So what do you see? Acceleration due to gravity, that is acceleration produced in the body, is independent of mass of the body. Is independent of mass of the body. So if we neglect the viscous drag, if we neglect the upthrust, the body, whatever shape, whatever size, whatever mass you take, it doesn't matter. Acceleration produced is independent of them. It only depends on gravitational constant, that is constant. It depends, so mainly we can say it depends on mass of the planet or the satellite or the body. It depends on, for example, Earth we are taking. So it will depend on mass of the Earth. It will depend on radius of the Earth. It will depend on mass of the Earth. It will depend on the radius of the Earth. Similarly, on Moon, it will depend on mass of the Moon, and radius of the Moon. Any planet, any star you take, it will depend on the mass and the radius of that particular planet, star, or satellite. So it is independent of mass of the body. It is independent of the shape and size of the body. This is clear. That's why we usually say, this g is nothing but acceleration due to gravity, and it is due to gravitational force of the Earth only. It means if a fat person is dropping and a thin person is dropping, both are going to reach the ground at the same time. Acceleration produced is same. And we say acceleration due to gravity. We call it as acceleration due to gravity. This is same for everybody. It is same for everybody. This is clear? So this is the relation between g and small g and capital G, acceleration due to gravity and gravitational constant. As well, you can see the example 76 on page number 76. Calculate the g of Earth. How much is the g of the Earth applied?
average is 9.8 newton.
So we can, if we calculate, if we put the gravitational constant 6.67 into 10 to the power minus 11, mass is how much? 5.76 into 10 to the power 24, I think. Yes. And radius 6.37 into 10 to the power 6, the whole square. If you calculate, g is coming how much? G of r.
9.8 meter
per second square. This is the value of g. Okay, and it is same for everybody. It is same for everybody because it does not depend on mass of the body. This is the acceleration produced due to gravitational force of the earth. And g of moon, how much you are getting? 1.6, I think something.
1.6 meter 1.6. Per
second square. 1.6 meter per second square. So g of moon is nearly about 1/6 of the earth. Nearly about 1/6 of the earth. Okay. Nearly about 1/6 of the earth. Is acceleration due to gravity on moon. Okay, so these all we have discussed. Now we discuss the free fall. This we have discussed earlier as well. Where we have discussed linear motion was there, some equations were there of uniformly accelerated body. Three equations were there of linear motion where it was uniformly accelerated motion. Yes. Three equations, yes. Which were there? V equal to U plus
U
80.
U plus 80. S equal to U plus half a t square. V square equals to U square minus 2.
Yes.
U square minus or plus?
Plus.
Plus.
Plus 2as. Okay. Minus if the motion is opposite to the acceleration produced. Retardation. Okay. That we have discussed. Now, CR, we are discussing free fall. If we are going for free fall, free fall means initial velocity will be what?
Zero.
U is zero. And what about the acceleration? It will be equal to g. This direction will be g. Okay. Now if we substitute them there, how they will be there? V equal to gt. S equal to half gt square, v square equal to 2gs. This is clear? V square equal to 2gs. These relations we get for the free fall of the body. Body is free falling. That is, at any instant, if you have to calculate the velocity, what you have to do? G into that. That is, after 2 seconds, you have to calculate 9.82. Okay? You can see the velocity. It will be how much? 0, velocity 0. After 1 second, what will be the velocity? If you use this one,
9.8 meter per second.
Meter per second. After 1 more second, that is 1 second only. These 2 seconds are passed, so it will be 9.8 into 2 seconds. How much?
19.6 meter per second.
Per second. You can see it is changing by 9.8 meter per second each second. That is the acceleration. Change is 9.8 meter per second each second. And again, after 1 second, 9.8
almost 27.
29.4 meter per second.
29.4 meter per second. Again, so you can see how the velocity is changing. Each time the velocity is increasing by each second, it is increasing by 9.8 meter per second. This is clear. So maximum velocity will be when? If this is the ground. Maximum velocity will be here. As it is just about to hit the ground. As it is just about to hit the ground, that will be the maximum velocity. That will be the maximum velocity at here. Yes? Have you understood this one?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay. If there's some velocity, if I throw with some velocity, that means you will be there. This time you will be there. If you are throwing with some velocity, initial velocity you are provided. It means this time it won't be free fall and u won't be equal to zero. It won't be equal to zero, there will be u. So in every equation, you will add u plus gt, u plus half gt square, u plus 2gs. Have you understood this one? It means if initial velocity I'm throwing with 2 meter per second, it means in each you will add 2 meter per second. Yes or no? because V equal to U plus GT will be there. S UT plus half GT square. V square equal to U square plus 2GS. Have you understood this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Next thing, this time we are throwing the body upward. If you are throwing the body upwards, so you'll be providing what? Some velocity you'll be providing. Let it be U. If you are throwing the body upwards, it means what will be the equation? V, U, plus or minus?
U minus.
Minus.
Minus. See here, motion is in this direction, acceleration is in this direction. U minus G T. And next one, S will be how much? UT minus half GT square. V square equal to U square minus 2GS. Okay. Now, if I say, what is the velocity at the highest point?
Zero.
Zero.
It will be zero. So see, as you throw the stone, first it goes, comes to rest, then comes again. Because constant force is acting. So deceleration, now acceleration coming back. Okay. So if U is given, you have to calculate the maximum height reached. How much is the maximum height reached? How you are going to calculate? Maximum height reached. So see how you are. So what has been given to you? U is given only, and you are asking H max, that is maximum height reached by the stone. So T is there. This equation again you will use. T is not given, so use the last. At the maximum height, what will be the velocity? Zero. Zero equal to U square minus 2th. This is H max, because this we have to calculate. At maximum height, its velocity will be zero. Now, 2G H max equal to U square. H max will be how much? U square upon 2G. U square upon 2G. This is the maximum height reached. Okay. Now, if I ask you, calculate the total distance. How much will be the total distance traveled by this body? H max plus H max again. Two times we will add height coming back to the same height. So, total distance covered will be how much? 2H max. That will be U upon G. That will be U upon G. This is clear? Okay. Now, calculate the time in traveling the H max. What will be the total time travel? How much time it will take to reach the maximum height? At maximum height, U will be zero, V will be zero, U minus GT equal to zero, T equal to U by, 1 minute, U by G. Here U square, okay, sorry. T equal to U by G. Time taken is how much? If you are throwing, is the maximum height, how much time it will take? U by G. And total time?
2U.
U by G plus U by G. 2U by G. 2U by G. Okay? This is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay? So we stop here. Mass and weight we will discuss in next lecture. Okay? Anything you want to ask?
What is the syllabus for the exam that is going to held
Thank
in
you, sir. Have a nice day.
Okay. Today I'm going to discuss with ma'am and then I'll let you know. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Study. See, okay, sir. Main book, sir. What I've been told, just keep on studying. Yes.
Thank you, sir. Have a nice day, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, I want to. Okay, 1 minute.